Hello, and welcome to Favorite Dish with Hank Huckle. I am Hank Huckle, and today we're here in front of my church with a special friend. Come on in here, special friend.
Hey, how are you?
It's Reverend Ben, my reverend here at our church. And, well, Reverend Ben, today you're going to teach us something special.
I'm going to teach you how to prepare my Brussels sprouts with special sauce.
Brussels sprouts with special sauce. Well, I can't wait to learn how to make this. It'll be so good.
Good.
Let's go into the kitchen and make some stuff.
Let's go.
All right.
Well, the first thing we do is we start with the Brussels sprouts. We wash them really well. We cut the bottom off. And then the really special thing is that you put this cross cut into every flour so that it opens up the sprout when it's cooking. So then we add some salt to them and let that sit. And the salt can stay on them for as long as you want, up to an hour or so.
Now, you told me after service last Sunday that you learned the salting technique from a Romanian woman.
I learned this whole recipe from an old Hungarian woman.
Boy, so this is an old recipe.
This is a pretty traditional Hungarian recipe for Brussels sprouts.
All right.
Yeah. Then the next step is to prepare the bacon. And you can either use a slab and make some cubes, or you can just take sliced bacon and cut it into pieces, which is what we've done today. This is uncured bacon. You could use onion, but I like to use shallot, and I like to dice it really fine. And I like to dice the garlic.
What happens now?
But now we go to the pan.
To the pan.
To the pan.
All right.
You want to heat your skillet up and add a little bit of bacon fat I like to use, or you can use any, you know, oil or even butter.
Well, it's hard to go wrong with bacon.
Hard to go wrong with that. And then you want to move the bacon, spread it out, add your shallot and garlic real quick and mingle all that. I look for the clarification of the shallot or the onion that I'm using with that. I don't want that to go brown, so I want that to be, you know, pretty translucent. That's when I add the sprouts. Moisture from the sprouts kind of slows down the cooking process, and I drop the temperature there.
Oh boy, okay.
Then you add the secret ingredient, wine.
Wine! Boy, that's a great secret ingredient for
that
church.
That makes every sprout taste better.
Oh yeah. All right.
But then you simmer that and let it cook for a while.
Okay.
Now this is a really nice, hearty dish. Something you might welcome Kendra home back home from one of her
trips abroad.
She's
been gone so long.
She's gone all the time.
She's gone all the time. She goes back home to see her mother.
How is her mother?
She's doing okay. Oh, I think she's so still doing marathons. So, you know, she's got to be.
Well, these will keep her going too. And then we just have our seasonings. We have kosher salt and really finely ground pepper and some Hungarian paprika.
Great. Boy, you just do that to taste?
Yeah.
Yeah. Boy, I love tasting spices at the end. There it is.
Here it is.
Brussels sprouts and bacon lardons. Boy, Kendra's just gonna love these when I share these Reverend Ben's.
Oh, I hope you
special
do.
Sprouts.
Oh, she will love them.
Oh yeah.
Tell me about your shirt.
Oh well, Kendra embroidered this for me. She takes an embroidery class.
I see it has a bee on it.
Oh yeah, that's from our first date. We both got stung by bees.
You were stung by love.
Stung by love and stung by bees.
Well, blessed be.
Oh, indeed. All right, everybody. Well, have a great time making sprouts at home. And Reverend Bren, thank you. Cheers. Bye, everybody. I really do like these.
I'm so glad.
Yeah. And you know, Kendra embroiders all kinds of things. You could ask her.
Well, what else does she embroider?
She does underwear.
Underwear?
Yeah, she has bees on the fly.
Well, how special that is.
It is. Yeah, I love it. I love to wear them because it just reminds me of Kendra.
I can imagine it does.
Yeah.